Michelle, I have to make an animation about spouse reversionary annuity, but I don't even know what that is. Could you briefly explain this concept to me?
Sure, Gary. First of all, do you know how an ordinary life annuity works?
I think so. It provides a series of future payments to the annuitant for as long as that person is alive.
That's right. And a spouse reversionary annuity is similar to an ordinary life annuity, except that it involves two lives instead of one.
And what does that mean exactly?
Following the death of the main annuitant, the annuity will continue to pay out to the spouse for the remainder of that person's life.
Okay, I can see how that would be useful to some people as it guarantees the financial safety of their spouses. So what's the catch?
The payment that the spouse receives will generally be of a reduced amount, such as being only half of what was paid to the original annuitant.
Right, but what happens if the spouse's death occurs before that of the main annuitant?
If the death of the spouse occurs first, then the annuity will just terminate upon the death of the main annuitant, and nobody else would be entitled to additional benefits.
Okay, I see. Does that mean a spouse reversionary annuity will always be more expensive than a non-reversionary annuity that has the same payment and frequency?
That's right, because the spouse reversionary annuity has all the features of an ordinary life annuity plus additional benefits when the spouse outlives the main annuitant.
Interesting. But what is the use of a spouse reversionary annuity when I am not even married?
You don't have to be married to your spouse. In a superannuation context, it is acceptable for a spouse to be a partner with whom you live together as a couple.
So in the event that my existing spouse dies or if we become separated, can I nominate a new reversionary beneficiary to take her place?
You are not allowed to change your reversionary beneficiary once nominated. Your current spouse will still receive a pension following your death even if you become separated.
That's terrible. I guess I'll just have to be careful with who I nominate as my beneficiary when buying a spouse reversionary annuity.
You do that.
Okay, I am now an expert on spouse reversionary annuity. But I still need you to show me how to turn everything you just said into an animation.